2019 rental predictions are in, estimated increases in Canada, and right here in Toronto tonight. What's behind the double-digit rise in rents that may hit the market here? York University remembers a victim of the Humboldt, Saskatchewan bus tragedy. Mark Cross played for the Lions before losing his life in the crash last year. Tonight, the team retires his jersey.
Canadian officials are in China this weekend, but they won't be calling for the release of two Canadians jailed in that country. Tonight, why the delegation is treading carefully when it comes to the issue of Canadian detainees.
Finding a new home here in Toronto is no easy task, and you can ask any renter here in the city, they'll tell you the same thing. Now, this is just one of the buildings in the downtown core. It's near Dundas and Church, currently being developed in the core. But brace yourselves, a new report is forecasting an upper market and predicting rent will increase by 11% this year in Toronto.
Yeah, I've been here for 2 months now, so I'm kind of new, looking to start living here as well, and it is scary. 11% is $333, which is, puts a big dent in everything, right? It's already hard enough to afford a nightmare.
Can I ask you first how much you pay for rent?
$3,000 a month.
For how many bedrooms?
Bedrooms.
Where? Like in
what area? City Place.
Sackett Ayala moved to Toronto from Calgary, where he still owns two homes. But here, he considers himself lucky to have found a rental unit downtown.
I have two mortgages that cost less than this combined, so it's harder, but it is, different markets, different price.
The rental market in the GTA is nothing less than competitive. In a new report from Rentals.ca and Bullpen Research and Consulting Inc. states 2019 is going to be tougher than ever for renters. 17 housing experts across Canada, from economists to data analysts, politicians, landlords, and rental advocates were involved in drafting this report. They're predicting renters across Canada will see an average 6% increase, but Toronto will see nearly double that, and they predict a 10% hike in Mississauga, 9% in Ottawa, and a 7% rise in Vancouver. The data coming from Toronto is based on vacated units, not rent-controlled buildings.
I took the Rentals.ca information, looked back 2 years, and just looked at a linear trend line of the data, and just pulled that forward to see where we thought it might go in 2019, and that led us to 11% growth.
How accurate would you say this report is?
Well, I guess we'll find out in a year, all right? This is the first time that we're doing this forecast.
What's behind the increase, the 11% increase?
So new stress test makes it harder for people to qualify for mortgage financing. They're signed to rent for longer. We've got record level of population growth in Ontario, so we're near a 40-year high in terms of population growth. So 250,000 more people in Ontario now than there were a year ago. Then you add nationally, we're at a record low unemployment rates.
According to the report, young couples and families have postponed buying homes. Ben Myers also believes the market is undersupplied by around 5,000 to 10,000 units, which is driving rent up and vacancy rates lower. Rent for a two-bedroom apartment in Toronto is predicted to increase to nearly $2,700 a month. This view isn't shared by another rental market analyst. Urban Nation is forecasting what it says is a more balanced market for renters this year, with pre-constructed condos providing some relief.
Most of the supply that we see coming to the rental market comes from condo investors. So investors that buy pre-construction units, and then when the projects finish construction, they rent the units out. So typically, half of a newly completed condo building will see the units go directly into the rental market. So when more of these condo buildings reach completion, it adds more rental supply. And this year, we could see 24,000 new condos reach completion, which would be a record year. And on top of that, we're going to see more traditional rental buildings reach completion, too. We're actually forecasting a record level of condo completions in 2019 and a 30-year high for rental completions as well. So with all of this new supply expected to come into the marketplace in 2019, we're expecting rents to grow still strongly by about 5%, but not quite as strong as they have over the last couple of years.
But this newcomer to Toronto doesn't believe he'll be a homeowner here anytime soon.
At some point, the pipe dream is to own it from here, but I don't think that's ever going to happen. So, we'll see.
As for the forecast in other parts of the GTA, the report states that both Oakville and Vaughan have the highest suburban markets, while Etobicoke, North, and East York will have a rate that, quote,
shooting help with the shooting investigation in the city's East End early yesterday morning. It happened at Walpole and Greenwood Avenues near Gerard Street East at about 2 a.m. They said two vehicles, both with a number of people inside, were parked in the area. A man reportedly approached the two vehicles on foot and began shooting at them. It was an exchange of gunfire, okay, and the man took off. Police say the man who fled did not appear to be injured, but say a person in one of the cars was shot. He underwent surgery and remains in life-threatening condition in hospital. Police released this photo today of a red Nissan Altima believed to be one of the vehicles involved. Anyone with information is asked to call police or Crime Stoppers. A man took himself to hospital tonight suffering from gunshot wounds. The man's injuries appear to be non-life-threatening. At this hour, we do not know the whereabouts or where in the city he was shot. In a tweet, shortly before 5 o'clock, Toronto police reported there were sounds of possibly 3 to 6 gunshots heard in the Lawrence Avenue West and Dufferin Street area. They have since confirmed they have found shell casings in that area. Police have yet to confirm, though, whether the man in hospital and the gunfire are connected. Yesterday, we brought you a story about three suspects facing charges in a human trafficking investigation involving Tinder. Police now say in a separate investigation, a man and a woman have been charged after a 17-year-old girl was allegedly picked up at school and forced to provide sexual services for money against her will in various condos and motels in the city. 22-year-old Patrick Akroon and 19-year-old Atruba Mugal, both of Toronto, are each facing 16 charges. And in a third separate incident, a 26-year-old Brampton man is facing charges after another 17-year-old girl was forced to work in the sex trade. Kristen Peter Miller is facing 12 charges. Police are worried there may be more victims from all of these incidents and are urging anyone affected by a sex crime to come forward.
Canadian officials are in China this weekend, but talk of the detained Canadians in that country will not be on the agenda. The head of the delegation, Senator Joseph Day, says he doesn't want to do anything to harm the welfare of Canadian detainees Michael Kovrig and Michael Spavor. The men were taken into custody on murky national security grounds last month, widely seen as retaliation for the RCMP's arrest of Huawei executive Meng Wanzhou at the request of their American counterparts. Senator Day says the purpose of the trip, which was planned months ago, is to promote business ties. And while he has no plans to bring up the Canadian detainees, he says if the issue does come up during the talks, his group will tread lightly in calling for their release. China has given only vague details of why they have detained Kovrig and Spavor, each of whom has had only one visit by the Canadian ambassador. Though China has not drawn a direct link to Meng's arrest, it has changed the tone in relations and deepened political tensions between Ottawa and Beijing. The group has had extensive briefings from Global Affairs and